Hi Fabs! So this video is going to be on a collection that was recently released by MAC. This is another designer collaboration between MAC and a fashion designer, and this time the collaboration is with Brazilian fashion designer Pedro Lourenço. So he released a collection of products and I purchased some, of course, and I wanted to share the products with you. First, here are the two lip glosses that were released in this collection. One is in mirror and then the other is in gold mirror. There were two lip glosses that were released with this collection, and the lip glosses are mirror, which is like a silverish sparkly glitter shade, and then gold mirror, which is just the gold version of it. And here is the lip gloss in mirror. And now here's the lip gloss in gold mirror. And here's gold mirror applied. It's actually very similar to mirror, but you can kind of see the gold tones of it. And basically, they're just metallic and multi-dimensional sparkly lip glosses. Now, there was a mix-up with the lip glosses from MAC, well, with orders from the MAC website. I'm not sure if this affected the department stores that sell and carry MAC, but it did affect all of the orders that were placed during the release from maccosmetics.com. And what happened was the lip glosses were mixed up. If you ordered the one in mirror, then you actually received gold mirror with the stickers saying that it was mirror on it. And if you ordered the one in gold mirror, you received mirror with a sticker that said it was gold mirror. So that was a slight mix up. Fortunately, since I ordered both of the lip glosses, I didn't really have an issue. The only thing that I had to do was just switch out these stickers on the bottom of my lip glosses, but people who only ordered one were more so affected by this and they had to contact MAC so that the situation could be resolved. So I just wanted to mention that. I'm not sure if this is an issue that happened with like Nordstrom.com or Macy's.com, but it definitely affected MACcosmetics.com. There were four lipsticks that were released in this collection as well, and all four of the lipsticks are amplified finished lipsticks. And there's a nude shade, which is peach beige, and it's actually a very light nude, but I'm wearing it today with some lip liner and some gloss, so you can definitely make the lighter nudes work for you. And it is super light. What I do with lipsticks like this is I really just concentrate the color of the lipstick in the centers of my lips. Then I'm just going to take a lip pencil, and this is Spice by MAC. And I just line the outer edges of my lips. And that's how I make lip colors like that work. I never wear a nude or very light lipstick without a lip liner, and you can do any color lip liner with this lipstick. This one is like a pinky nude, but you can use like a more caramel or brown tone pencil or anything like that, and you can do a really nice gradient effect, and you can also add a gloss or something like that on top, and this is really going to give a really nice dimensional lip. That's what I like to use light lipsticks like this for. And then there were three red shades. The one in True Red. This one is very similar to Lady Danger. And here is True Red from the collection, and here is Lady Danger. Now the difference is definitely in the finish. Lady Danger is a matte finish, and matte finishes can sometimes be very drying on the lips, whereas amplified finishes are very hydrating. They're very very smooth and silky on the lips. So the colors are very similar, but if, for example, Lady Danger is a bit too drying from you and that kind of deters you from wearing it, then I would definitely recommend the shade in True Red. And here is the lipstick in True Red. It's a really nice, actually orangey tone red, or a orange red, red orange, but it's a very beautiful color. And here's a swatch of them just for comparison. This is True Red at the top, and this is Lady Danger here at the bottom. So they're very similar in color. The main difference is definitely that finish on them. And another one of the lipsticks that I wanted to just mention that I did really enjoy was this one in Roxo. It's a beautiful deep berry color, and I really like this color. Very beautiful, like I said, and it would be a great color to wear now, but definitely in the fall and winter. And here is the lipstick in Roxo. Now, the one in Ruby is really nothing special to me. I really could have done without this shade. It's nothing really special, and I have a ton of reds, but the true standouts in the reds were definitely the True Red and the Roxo shade, in my opinion. And here is the lipstick in Ruby. There was a blush compact release in this collection, and it's this one here, and I love the packaging. Let me show you the packaging on the lipsticks from the collection compared to the regular permanent matte packaging. Now, the packaging on the collection lipsticks, it's kind of like a rubberized plastic on the exterior, and it's in a matte black. It's sort of very similar to the packaging on like the NARS blushes and things like that. And then it has gold detailing on it opposed to the typical silver detailing. Here's the blush compact, and it's very, very beautiful. You have that gold detailing around the compact powder. You have the split blush pan, and this shade is in Coral, and this top portion is a matte finish, and then the bottom portion is a satin finish. I am wearing the blush on my cheeks right now. When you swatch the blush, how it applies and the color payoff you get is dramatically different from the product that you get when you actually apply it using a brush to your cheeks. You get a nice pigmentation and color saturation when applying this with your brush like I normally do, or like you would normally do. Swatches of the blush. Now, it's kind of difficult to get the swatches to pick up the true color since I'm just trying to swatch it with my fingers, but I'm telling you guys, when you apply this using just any blush brush, you're going to get a really beautiful color that's very subtle to where it can go with any type of eye makeup look or color combinations, but it's still going to apply and add a really gorgeous flush of color. And I am wearing it on my cheeks right now, just very lightly. I could have definitely gotten more color, pigmentation, and intensity if I wanted to, but I just wanted a nice soft flush. There was also an eyeshadow quad that was released with this collection that I decided to go ahead and purchase, and it's this quad here. Again, here's the packaging on the quad. Really beautiful, has that gold mirror reflection as the base of the palette. And here are the eyeshadows from the quad swatched. This shade here is limited edition and is a new shade for the powder. This one is Pink Sands, and it's a really gorgeous, just light pink color. And it is a matte finish. This one here in the center is a soft brown, and it's also a matte finish. And this is a new and limited edition shade that was released in the palette. And this one is Rose Cloud. This one here is one of MAC's permanent eyeshadows, and this is All That Glitters. So you can get this anytime. It's not unique to this palette. All That Glitters is a Voluxe Pearl finish. And this bottom shade here is also just a permanent MAC shadow, so it's not unique to this quad. You can pick it up anytime, and this is Sable, and it's a frost finish. What I do love about this quad are the colors. It's so beautiful, and this is a very rare quad for me because I can actually create looks using just this quad. Usually with the few other MAC quads that I have from older collections, I usually have to use some of my other eyeshadows to create just an entire look because there won't be a mixture in finishes. I love that you get two matte shades and then two shimmer shades because you can definitely create a full-on complete eye look using this. You can do something that's just soft and subtle for daytime wear, or you can go really sultry and smoke it out for a nighttime look. So really fabulous quad. The shadows are beautiful. They're pigmented. They're soft in texture but not chalky, and they're very easy to blend and work with. So I hope that you all enjoyed this video. If you would like to take another look at the photos, you can check them out on my blog. I will have it linked down below. If you guys picked up anything from this collection, please let me know what you picked up from the collection or what you thought of the collection down below in the comments. And until my next video, make sure to stay fabulous and don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Bye guys!